Hello everyone, I hope you're fine. Daniel Pizak speaking. I hope you will learn a lot of new stuff regarding 3D Experience Cotillia. Something is not that new. It has been introduced in 3D Experience since a couple of years, but now it's available on the cloud. It's Weight and Balance Designer. I will start with that. But you will see that, of course, if you reduce the weight of your product, if you monitor everything happening to this weight, this particular target of weight during the product development, you are starting, in fact, eco-design. You are starting to think sustainability. And you will see that we took the opportunity of having this weight and balance designer role in 3D Experience to add new capabilities to take into account the impact, to assess the impact of the product you are designing and measure its environmental footprint. And this is the target of a new role. In fact, there are multiple roles, but from Katia, there is a new role called Eco Designer. And I will talk about this Eco Designer role in the second part of the presentation. So let's start. So here we go. Here we are. Okay. My name is no longer Daniel. I am Jack. And Jack is a motorbike product manager. And this is the current weight of my bike. You can see also the center of gravity, the inertia matrix in the widget weight and balance. So I will just try to improve the performance and the weight criteria of this of the transmission. I would like to reduce the weight of my bike. So I would like now to work on the motorbike transmission and see how we can change that. So I just drag and drop the rear wheel transmission assembly that I selected in my product structure editor. This is a web app, okay? Here so far, everything is web app. You don't have to install anything on your laptop or desktop. You can run it through a web browser. So this is the actual weight, 95 kilo for my rear wheel transmission. And something maybe you are not aware of, a nice capability of 3D Experience Cotillia, I will duplicate my assembly, but in a very smart way, you'll see. So this is the duplication tool. And in fact, depending on the part, depending on these sub-assemblies, I will select the fact that I would like to reuse it or to duplicate. Duplicate means I will probably modify it or maybe ignore it, okay? It's exactly what we are doing here. I will select one part to be duplicate, which is the swing arm. And I will also ignore the tire, okay? Because I would like probably to change the tire to reduce the weight by taking another reference to my tire supplier. So here we are. This is the rear wheel transmission. This is the display in the 3D Compose view. I have my product structure on the lower right, left end. And I have my widget called business target definition. I am the manager. I will define a target for my team in terms of weight, in terms maybe of center of gravity, in terms of maybe inertia. And I will then distribute this target to my team. Here we are. So I have the current swing arm, which is called aluminum, and I have a new one that we would like to modify. So I start by giving a target. So let's say 82 kilos, not to exceed 93 and not to less to be less than lighter than 91. This is my target. And I will talk about that later on. The weight is, by the way, a human activity. Not the weight, but the weight is a criteria which is probably taken into account in multiple human activities to assess the environmental impact. But we'll see that later. Okay. So let's select a weight, give a budget for the weight of the new tire I will add to my bike. Sorry for the jaggies. So my budget weight for the new tire is 4.8 kilo. And that's it. That's my job. My job is done. Now I change my cap. I'm no longer Jack. I am Carol, a lady who's designing in my team. And Carol will try to reach the task that I ask her to do, which is to reduce the weight of the tire and the weight of the swing arm. So this is the actual weight. Of course, I am over target by 3%, 2.7 kilos. I have also a budget for my tire of 4.8 kilo. You see here, we have the dispatching of the weight of this rear transmission with the various parts components of this sub-assembly. The rear wheel, the gearbox, and so on, the wheel rim. And the idea is to reduce the swing arm. Now, one way of reducing the swing arm weight, you could have changed the material, but I will keep the same material, but I will use our generative design tool, function generative design. It's in a role called structural generative design on 3D experience to reduce the shape, in fact, the volume of mass of the swing arm. So as you know, we are defining the specifications such as the material, the boundary condition, the loads, the target of maximizing the stiffness of the swing arm, but minimizing the mass. Very, very cool capability of 3D experience cut here. I here double check that everything is fine from a displacement maximum stress point of view. Looks good to me. Now I check my current tire and have a look at the new one, the Optima one, which is not only lighter, but also more performing and give better feeling to the bike driver. Here we are. This is my new rear suspension. And I will go back to my widget, weight and balance. Now I have to take into account those modifications. So as you can see here, there were some missing values. In fact, the one for the new tire and the one for the swing arm. So for the wing tire, I will just declare the new weight because it's an information coming directly from my supplier. There are various ways in weight and balance. So weight can be declared, they can be measured, the actual real weight of the part. They can be computed because we know the volume and we know the material and the density. They can be overwritten. So you can really manage during the life cycle and the product development of the product, all the weights. And of course, it's a tool that is very, very useful for the manager because he can check whether one particular sub-assembly is going over target and make the right decision early in the design process and not at the very end. So I will declare the weight of the tire which is provided by the supplier. This is the info that I can declare. And for the swing arm, I will just recompute the volume. I know the density and I can get the swing arm new mass. I save my modification. I go back to the design intelligence widget weight and balance, which is here. You see, it's very simple. No complex dialog box. It's very, very straightforward UI, user interface. And my target is achieved. I am 92 kilo. Let's have a look if really everything's fine in terms of center of gravity. You can display the center of gravity. You can display the inertia as well, the inertia matrix in 3D. Here we are. Looks good to me. I have here the orange box, which is a simplified representation. And now Jacques, the product manager, will double check what I did and see if I'm on target. So you can see here the various structural distribution. So the weight from the various components, their role in the final weight. I can do this particular monitoring of the information even on a smartphone, because this is a pure web app, as I stated earlier. And I would probably be able also to compare where I am. So this was my initial target. I was out of the box, I would say out of target, but now today, thanks to Carol's job, I'm back on track. So for the weight trend, for the life cycle trend, but also from the business and budget trend. So it's very simply done. I can now, if I want, compare the two of them. So I will just drag and drop in the comparison tool, the two options, my two designs. And I have here a comparison of the weight. I could have selected another criteria. And this is typically the job of both a mechanical designer, Carol, who was just feeding the information, and myself, Jacques, as a manager, to double check that everything and is fine and that I am on target. So this is the weight and balance role, weight and balance designer role, okay, Katia role. Now we extended this, let's say, philosophy to something much broader. And rather than starting by just showing you how it works, I have to explain a little bit the principle of what we called eco-design in a 3D experience criteria. Let's see. This is just my comparison. I'm fine with that. Okay, it's a new role. In fact, there are three roles, one for criteria, for the designer, one for the manager, one for the data analytics specialist. And let's see here, I will focus on the role dedicated to the engineer, to the designer, okay? Let's start with some definition. The idea is very simple. We want to assess the impact of what you are doing when you are designing this product or manufacturing the product or transport the product or recycle the product to check if from a sustainability point of view, you are fine, okay? So how do we measure the environmental impact? In fact, it's quite simple. We have human activities. Those human activities and processes are consuming natural resources. They are releasing pollutants. And we can measure that. We can make a score, an environmental impact score with multiple methods, okay? Let's move forward. Okay, in fact, there are multiple type of impact for the human, damage to the human health, damage to the ecosystem. Damage to the human health can be, for example, the ozone layer decrease, okay? Damage to the ecosystem can be, for example, we have less water, or we use too much water, or we have less land, and also damage to resource availability. It can be the decrease of fossil resources or minerals and metals decreased or reduction. So from those environmental impacts, the idea is really to assess what you are doing, what your product is doing in service, what a service is doing, and we take into account all the stages, as I stated earlier, from raw material extraction through distribution, through repair, and why not up to recycling, okay? That sets the life cycle assessment. Oop. And of course, it's not that simple, but we try to make it very simple for Katia users, okay? United Nations have classified the activities. There is an international standard for industrial classification called ISIC, and to assess environmental impact of what you are doing, of your product, 13 of the 21 categories which are appearing in the ISIC classification have been taken into account. I just take a small example. So 13, for example, construction, manufacturing, mining and quarrying, can be also agriculture, forestry, fishing, and so on. And I take a very simple example, transportation of goods by a truck. So the ISIC category is called transport by road. The activity could be freight, lorry, metrics, ton and euros. There is some indicator, the CO2, and there are some formula. The formula is computed by the weight of the products that you are carrying in your truck and some specific formulas, okay? Same for example, the electricity production from an hydro power plant. Some parameters, called so-called eco drivers, the power consumption, the estimated time, and some formula with those parameters. So we have human activities, and thanks to a partnership we have with the EcoInvent Association, we will enrich the virtual twin of our product by affecting, assigning human activities. There may be multiple activities for a given part, And this is what you will see during the presentation of the user interface of the product. So once those human activities have been assigned to the virtual twin, to every single part of your product, then you can measure the final score. There are multiple environmental methods to compute this score. The one from Europe is called EF 3.0, but we are in 3D Experience managing five of them. And you will see that it's very simple to get the score of your product. If I take, for example, the European one, they have selected 16 key indicators. So we will compute the impact of the human activities according, let's say, against those 16 key indicators, and you will have your final score. That's the theory. Let's have a look at how it works in the role called Katia Eco Design Engineer. It's very, very simple, but powerful. Okay, the idea is to explain to you how I will measure, how I compute the environmental impact with the EF 3.0, for example, method, the European one, for this particular device, so-called BIMI, okay? So let's start. I go in my app as a manager to define the target definition. CO2, water use, land use, whatever. You define your target as a manager for producing this product the most efficiently. It's an innovative product, but it should be also sustainable. That's the idea, the main idea of this eco designer role. So as a manager, I define the target. So CO2, the targeted value is 53 kilos. Maybe water use, I would put a target of 15 cube meters. It's not an area, it's a volume. Once I'm doing this, I will now assign some human activities to enrich the virtual twin. What is important to understand is how the part, for example, this blue casing, is designed, produced. How is the material that we are using, for example, to do the injection molding of this plastic part, is extracted and so on. Okay, so it's very simple. You just now navigate through the 18,000 human activities that have been classified thanks to the EcoInvent association with their EcoInvent database, and the version is 3.7 if you ask. You select your categories, for example, manufacturing. I manufacture plastic products, and I will use for this plastic product injection molding. Oops, again, sorry for the jaggies. So I navigate, and then I affect my human activities to all the parts within my virtual twin of my product. That's first thing. I can also, for example, transport this part, or maybe the mold, if I am an injector, if I have some injection machine, sorry, inside my shop floor. So I define the distance that the lorry will cover, for example, 450 kilometers in this particular case. And this will have a cost in terms of environmental impact, okay? And now I would like to, because it's possible in 3D experience, I would like to add a new human activity which was not categorized already by the EcoInvent database. And for example, it will be a human activity to produce the actual 8-watt speaker which is inside my my BIMI. I can define, you know, some formulas for for example, the CO2 emission. It will be the weight of this plastic coverage plus a given formula, a tolerance, a confidence in this value. Here we are. So I have defined my new activity. I have selected existing activity. I will now affect, reuse, assign this newly designed activity, which is only for my company, to the enrichment of the virtual twin of my BIMI product. Here we are. And I will also now declare some CO2 parameter, and selecting now the environmental method, for example, EF 3.0, Katia will automatically compute a score for the 16, if I am in EF 3.0, for the 16 criteria, indicators, and of course, compute as well the final score. And if it's not fine for me, if I cannot get, for example, an eco label, if it's too high, I will deep dive into the product to see how I can improve this score. So it was over my target in terms of CO2. I have to check which one of the component within the BME is the most contributing to this bad score. Battery, PCB boards, but also the ABS plastic, which is used in my casing. And you can see there is a cross highlight between the distribution, the role of, or the importance of all those components for towards the bad score and the 3D on the screen. So I know exactly which part is contributing the most to the bad score again. And then I can even check in what life cycle stage. Is it manufacturing? Is it raw material extraction? Is it after recycling and so on? Where the score is the worst? In what area? Here, maybe manufacturing, because with my injection molding of my ABS material, which is of course ABS is plastic, is made of oil. So if I deep dive in or drill down on the fossil decrease indicator, fossil depletion indicator, I can check what is the environmental footprint. And maybe one idea is to change the material. So I see here all this top human activity impact, from electricity production to electronic production, and so on and so on. And I will change the material and replace ABS by a recycled plastic. I will now compare the BME classic ABS and the new recycled plastic with a new material. My footprint looks okay to me. I can then compare the two options and see in what area, in which of the 16 for the FE 3.0 method is impacted. And very quickly, I can define some alternatives. So it's a tool not only to assess the environmental impact, but also to make the right choice at the very, very beginning, not when the part is started to be produced in the shop floor or by my suppliers. You can make very important decision to reduce the environmental impact. Maybe again, to get more, to be more competitive with your competitors. And more maybe attractive for the end user, which is looking more and more at the sustainability score. So it's very important. And as you can see as well, it's very, very simple to use. Here's just a comparison of the CO2 emission between the two options with ABS and with the recycled material. So there are other roles in the platform for the people defining the target, for the people defining the value of all those parameters, and as an eco designer for myself to use when I'm designing in 3D Experience Katia, those information, very, very valuable information, to make the right choice, to make the right product, and make the product successful. Here we are. Thank you very much for your attention. Remember that if you go to the Katia user community, go.3ds.com/Katia, you will have much more information. You can have also a replay of all the Katia Jewel talks. This was the 15th. So next year we'll continue, of course, because it's always a pleasure to be with you. We can continue again the conversation by chatting directly on the community. And just to finish, because it's the end of the year and we are close to Christmas, I wish you a very, very happy Christmas. Thank you. Take care of yourself. Take care of your family. Enjoy Christmas time.